I'm Chicago Tribune reporter Jennifer Weigel reporting from the Tribune studios. And joining me via Skype is columnist Steve Rosenblum. Hey, Steve, it's kind of interesting to not have an overtime with a Blackhawks game. We win 5-2, and I was in bed by 10:30. How cool was that?
That was a terrific performance, must-win game. It was win or walk, win or stay home, and they won. And they got the boy band back together. They got Taves and Kane, put them on the same line in the first period. Usually that's the nuclear option. Quenneville goes to late. He went early. He wasn't getting this. He did not get the start he wanted. He wasn't getting the offense he wanted. He put them together. Kane had a goal and an assist. Brandon Saad, the third member of that line, had a goal. Jonathan Taves went 10-2 in faceoffs, and they beat the Ducks. It was a terrific performance with the best line being the best line.
It was the band back together, and I'm so glad that that produced those results. But wouldn't you say Duncan Keith was probably the best player of Game 6?
He was. He was the guy. In the Blackhawks system, it's really easy to tell how their chances are going to go. If Duncan Keith is going, the Blackhawks are going. Their offense starts with their defense. Their defense starts with Duncan Keith. Okay. He set up three goals, and then he swept a puck off the goal line after the Ducks had cut the deficit to 3-1, and shortly thereafter were looking to make it 3-2. He does everything. He is their Conn Smythe Trophy candidate. He's been the best player on this team in the playoffs, top to bottom.
This is far from over. Game 7 Saturday at 7 p.m. How do you think we're going to do?
I got to go with the experience. I got to go with the team that's done this. The Ducks, meanwhile, have lost 3-2 leads in the last two playoff years, and they've lost Game 7s at home. I'm going with the Hawks.
Okay. We will see how it all pans out, and we'll talk with you soon. Thanks so much, Steve.
Thanks, Jen.